who feel numb and crushed and are filled with the pain of grief, whose strength has given up. You know all our sighings and longings. Be near us and teach us to fix our hope on you. Through Christ our Lord. Lord, have mercy on those who mourn, who feel numb and crushed, and are filled with the pain of grief, whose strength has given up. You know all our sighings and longings. Be near us and teach us to fix our hope on you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. May the Lord grant mercy to the house of Onesiphorus, for he often refreshed me and was not ashamed of my chain. But when he was in Rome, he sought me diligently and found me. The Lord grant to him to find the Lord's mercy on that day, and in how many things he served at Ephesus, you know very well. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. love of the God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies, and the God of all consolation. He comforts those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from Him. The Lord is my shepherd. Your response, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where He gives me repose. Near restful waters He leads me to revive my drooping spirit. Your response, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
He guides me along the right path. He is true to His name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff. With this you give me comfort. Your response, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. Your response, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. Your response, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, hear our prayers and be merciful to your son, Jerome Douglas Fernandez, whom you have called from this life. Welcome him into the company of your saints in the kingdom of light and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. Father, God of all consolation, in your unending love and mercy for us, you turn the darkness of death in the dawn of new life. Show compassion to your people in their sorrow. Be our refuge and our strength to light us from the darkness of this grief to the peace and light of your presence. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying for us, conquered death, and by rising again, restored life. May we then go forward eagerly to meet Him, and after our life on earth, be reunited with our brothers and sisters, wherever tears will be wiped away. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of the God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I bless the body of Jerome Douglas Fernandez with the holy water that recalls his baptism, of which Saints Paul writes, all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by the likeness to his resurrection. On the day of his baptism, he puts on Christ in the day of Christ's coming. May he be clothed with all glory. Father, in your hands we commend our brother. We are confident that we all who have died in Christ, he will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave him in this life, to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord, hear our prayer. welcome our brother to paradise and help us to comfort each other in the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with you our brothers forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and the eternal Jerusalem. Amen. In the flowers. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Father, God, Holy Spirit, be with you all. I bless the body of Christ and the love of the Lord.
Thank you. प्रार्थना करते करते
especially his doctors. So, my dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Servant Jerome Douglas Fernandez, we pray, O Lord, from every bond of sin, that he who in this world was found worthy to be conformed to Christ may be raised to the glory of the resurrection and draw the breath of new life among your saints through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. The souls of the righteous are in the hands of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they would seem to have died, and their departure was though to be an affliction, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they were at peace. For those in the sight of men, they were punished. Their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the name of their visitation, they will shine forth and will run like sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over people, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who have trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Chapter 23, verses from 39 to 43. When they came to the place which is called the Skull, there they crucified Jesus and the criminals, one on the right and the other one on the left. One of the criminals who were hanged railed at him, saying, "Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God? Since you are under the same sentence of condemnation, and we endure justly, for we are receiving the due reward from our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." And he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come in your kingly power." And he said to him, "Truly, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our church and the good of all his church.
Grant our supplication, we pray, O Lord, that this sacrifice may benefit your departed servant, Jerome Douglas Fernandez, since through his offering you have loosed the offenses of all the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim. Fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, I entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of body and blood of Christ, we may gather into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Susie Pakiam, our Archbishop, Kustodas, our Auxiliary Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Jerome Douglas Fernandez, whom you have called today by this will to ourselves. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who has died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
As the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to sing. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from our evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Be safe in eternal life.
Thank you. I'd like to speak a few words for Dada. So let me start by saying that I have lost my beloved godfather. Yes, he was my godfather, a kind, loving, caring father, uncle, husband, brother, son, and so much more. You have left a void that no one can fill. The fond memories we all have of you are countless. His relationship with everyone in the family was so unique, and in his own way, the respect and love he had for Appu is something we can all emulate, I feel. I especially remember the times when he took me to the kindergarten, all the times he dropped me at the bus stop, when he took me to Uncle Mel's bakery for cake, puff, and the time when we used to play games and he would find crooked ways to win, the numerous parties when he would play the mouth organ and crack poor jokes. Dada, you were always around us, and you helped nurture all of us. We will miss you. Your cheerfulness, your love, and all your fatherly advice and interesting stories from so many years back. We wish we had more time with you. But God saw you were getting tired, and he saw us watch you suffer. And I guess God only takes away the best, so he decided to take you today. I'd like to conclude with a quote. So grieve with me for a while. Grieve me for a while. If grieve you must, then let your grief be comforted by trust that it is only for a while that we must part. So treasure the memories within your heart. Goodbye, our dearest Dagi Dada, until we meet again.
May the sacrifice of your church, we pray, O Lord, benefit the soul of your servant Jerome Douglas Fernandez, so that he who received the sacrament of Christ's mercy may enter his company together with joy in your saints, through Christ our Lord.
ശിക്ഷ നൽകുന്നു. വിയർപ്പും ജീവനുമായ ഈ ദാസനെ മഹത്വത്തോടെ ഉയർപ്പിക്കുന്ന അയ്യാടെ ശരീരയുടെ വിശ്രമം കൊണ്ടുമാറാകട്ടെ. അങ്ങയുടെ ദിവ്യ തേജസ്സിൽ പിതാവ് ദൈവത്തിരുത്തൽക്കം ദർശിക്കുവാൻ ഇവളെ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുകയും എന്നെന്നും ജീവിച്ചു വാഴുകയും ചെയ്യുന്ന അമ്മയോട് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. നമ്മുടെ ഈ സഹോദരൻ ജെറോം ഡഗ്ലസ് ഫെർണാണ്ടസ് സർവശക്തനായ ദൈവം ഈ ജീവൻ തന്റെ പക്കലേക്ക് വിളിക്കുവാൻ മനസ്സായി. മണ്ണിൽ നിന്നെടുത്ത ശരീരത്തെ നാം ഇപ്പോൾ മണ്ണിൽ തന്നെ നിക്ഷേപിക്കുന്നു. മരിച്ചവരിൽ നിന്നും ക്രിസ്തുനാഥൻ ആദ്യമായി ഉയർത്തെഴുന്നേറ്റു എളിയവരായ നമ്മുടെ ശരീരങ്ങളെ അവിടുന്ന് ഉയർത്തിക്കുമെന്നും തന്റെ തേജോമയമായ ശരീരത്തോട് അനുരൂപപ്പെടുത്തുമെന്നും നാം വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവിന്റെ തിരക്കാലങ്ങളിൽ ഈ സഹോദരനെ നമുക്ക് ഏൽപ്പിക്കാം. ഇയാൾക്ക് അവിടെ നിത്യശാന്തി നൽകി അവസാന ദിവസം ഇയാളുടെ ശരീരത്തിൽ ഉയർത്തുകയും ചെയ്യുമാകട്ടെ. ജീവന പുനരുദ്ധാനവും ഞാനാകുന്ന എല്ലാ വിശ്വാസം മനസ്സിലാക്കി ജീവിക്കുന്ന ചെറിയ കർത്താവ് യേശുക്രിസ്തുവിനോട് ഈ സഹോദരനോട് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കാം. ലാസറിന്റെ ശവം കൂടിയിട്ട് നിങ്ങൾ കണ്ണീർ പക്ഷ കർത്താവെ ദുഃഖാത്തര ഞങ്ങളുടെ കണ്ണ് നീരത്തുടച്ച് നീക്കണമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. മരിച്ചവരെ ഉയർപ്പിച്ച കർത്താവ് ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഈ സഹോദരന് നിത്യായുസ് നൽകണമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. പശ്ചാത്തപ്പച്ചകളുടെ പ്രദേശം വാഗ്ദാനം ചെയ്ത കർത്താവ് ഈ സഹോദരന്റെ സ്വർഗീയ സൗഭാഗ്യത്തിലേക്ക് ആനയിക്കണമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവിന് ജ്ഞാനസ്ഥാന ജലമൊഴി കഴിഞ്ഞ വിശുദ്ധതയിലും കൂടെ അഭിഷേകം ചെയ്ത ഈ സഹോദരന്റെ വിശുദ്ധരുടെയും തെരഞ്ഞെടുക്കപ്പെട്ട വിഘടനത്തിൽ ചേർക്കണമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ഞങ്ങളുടെ തിരുശരീരത്തിലേക്ക് നൽകി പരിപോഷിപ്പിച്ച ഇയാളെ സ്വജീവിതത്തിൽ പങ്കാളിയാക്കണമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. തവി സഹോദരന്റെ വേർപാട് ദുഃഖിതരായ കുടുംബാംഗങ്ങൾക്ക് ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് വിശ്വാസം ആശ്വാസം നൽകുകയും നിത്യജീവൻ പ്രത്യാശ ഉള്ളതും ചെയ്യണമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ഞങ്ങളുടെ പിതാവേ കർത്താവായ ദൈവമേങ്ങയുടെ തിരുവള നിറവേറ്റത് സർവദാ ജാഗ്രത കാണിച്ച ഈ ദാസം ചെയ്തു പോയ തെറ്റുകൾ ദയാവനം ക്ഷമിക്കണമേ. സത്യവിശ്വാസ വഴി ക്രിസ്തീയ സമൂഹത്തിൽ ഉൾപ്പെടുത്തുവാൻ ഭാഗ്യം ലഭിച്ച ഇയാളെ കാരണിവനങ്ങ് മാലാത്മാരുടെ സമുദ്ര ചേർത്തല്ലേടമേ. കർത്താവായ ക്രിസ്തുവിൽ സമർപ്പിക്കുന്ന പ്രാർത്ഥന കേട്ടില്ലേടമേ. കർത്താവെ ഇയാൾക്ക് നിത്യവിശ്രാന്തി നൽകണമേ.
ഞാൻ ദൂരെ വന്നാ പറ്റില്ല. Thank you.
Thank you.